underwater world of the California Channel Islands. For over 10 years, we've been out here watching and recording sea animals and plants. After sunset, we dived with lights because at night, sea creatures come out to feed. At night, they weren't afraid to come close, but by day, they would have scurried away. Garibaldi as it closely guards its eggs, and we document it all on film. Life of the Santa Barbara Channel Islands is a montage of color. The corals decorate the reefs with purples and pinks. The red pelagic crab floats in from the open ocean. The kelp beds provide shelter for the millions of tiny animals, this while transparent salps drift in with the ocean currents. The shallow island reefs are heavily populated communities. On the sand and mud bottom of the channel, though, life is less evident. However, we're soon to learn about artificial reefs, the oil platforms. Shane Anderson, a marine biologist from Santa Barbara, told us that we should make a dive beneath one of the offshore oil platforms in the channel. He said we'd be surprised. Well, we dive underneath one of the nearshore platforms and discover a subsea oasis. At the platforms, we find numerous fishes attracted to the cross pilings. We visit the platform at night, and we again watch the animals come out to feed. There is so much life underneath the platforms that we have to ask, how did it all get there? The answer is plankton. Plankton. It looks like dirty water, but it's really the microscopic larva of fishes and invertebrates. When the water is full of plankton, this is what it looks like. A bare platform is soon covered with hydroids, an algae brought in by the currents. Barnacles arrive at the platforms as microscopic larvae. They settle and grow in the pilings. Mussels attach themselves to the platform, and they grow. The crabs also arrive as planktonic larvae, and they settle down, camouflaging themselves in the protection of their new ocean home. Starfishes are everywhere, eating the mussels. Brittle stars, odd spidery creatures, extending their arms, capturing passing food. And even the snails find a home amid the mussels. From sea urchins to anemones, almost everything makes its way to the platform as plankton. The platform offers a shelter for the animals, a place to grow and procreate, to build an ever-expanding reef, a unique underwater community. Soon, the platform is a riot of colors. Anemones carpet the pilings in reds, oranges, and greens. The corals find their place to grow. Nudibranchs, those lovely, colorful sea slugs, feeding as they inch along the platform reef.
And this concludes part one of A Better Way.